A very good morning to all of you. Welcome to class 11th Business Studies. In yesterday's class, we have already summed up with the chapter number one of BSG, that is Nature and Purpose of Business, where we have studied already that what is the nature of business, what is business, how business is an economic activity, how business is different from the other economic activities such as we have profession and employment, what are the various types of businesses, trade, auxiliaries to trade, what are the different types of trade, what are the different auxiliaries to trade, objectives of business. That all we have covered, business risk, that all we have covered in chapter number one. Now, chapter number two is a little bit different from chapter number one because it is about the business and different forms of business available to us, which means if suppose you want to start a business, then what are the various forms available by which you can start the business? We will be studying in this chapter. Like the very first you can see on your screen is sole proprietorship. This is the first form of business, Bete. This is the first form of business. Sole proprietorship. Sole means individual. Proprietorship means ownership, which means when you have the single ownership, when you have the sole ownership in your business, that is known as sole proprietorship business. So it is very simple. Sole proprietor means this will be that business in which you will only be the person who is doing the business. That means there is no one else who will be there with you in this business. You will be the king of your business. You will be taking all your decisions yourself. You will be deciding that when you have to come to the business, when you have to go from the business. You will be the single owner of this business. This is first form of ownership, first form of business. Like you have ample of examples nearby your house. There is a barber shop. There is one owner. He is running with the sole proprietorship. There is a grocery shop. He is running with the sole proprietorship. There are dry cleaners. There are jewelers. There are so many people who are into the sole proprietorship business. How will you identify that this particular business is a sole proprietorship? You will simply identify by that he will be the sole owner. He will be the single owner. No one else would be there. He will be the single owner who is actually doing the business. That is known as sole proprietorship. I hope somewhere you have got the view of sole proprietorship. That what is sole proprietorship. Now, after the sole proprietorship, the second business you can start is joint Hindu family business. This is the second form of business that you can start. Joint Hindu family business. But Abhi, I'm just giving you the viewpoint of all different forms of business available. In detail, we are going to study each one of them. We'll be studying each one of them in detail. But Abhi, just I'm giving you an overview that what are the various forms of businesses available. So the second form of business available is joint Hindu family business. As the name says, Hindu family means it is as per the Hindu law. It is mainly made for the Hindu people because it is as per the Hindu law, right? Secondly, joint. Joint means here we are talking about the joint families. So in this type of business, all family members who are living in a joint family, they can start their business. There would be one person, the topmost holder. He would be the karta. Who is the karta? Karta is that person who is ultimately the head of the family. The karta will run that business, and all other members of the family, which are under him, the other ages people, they will just follow the decisions taken by karta. They will follow the decisions taken by karta. That is joint Hindu family business. You know, for being into this business, one thing is very much necessary, that you must have born in the joint family. You must live in the joint family. And secondly, there should be some ancestral property. Ancestral property means purkho ki jameen, purkho ka business, jisko aap aage continue karte hue chale ja rahe hain. That is joint Hindu family business. बेटे उसको हम बोलते हैं जॉइंट हिंदू फैमिली बिजनेस. एग्जाम्पल देते हैं आपको बेटे, व्हेन यू गो टू द चांदनी चौक और यू गो टू द चावड़ी बाजार, यू गो टू द न्यू दिल्ली एरिया, यू विल फाइंड देयर मेनी बिजनेसेस सच एज मैसल्स, रोहित एंड सन्स, मैसल्स कपूर एंड सन्स, मैसल्स मोहन एंड सन्स, मैसल्स सोहन एंड सन्स. बेटे जिसके पीछे ये एंड सन्स लगा होता है, दैट इज अ जॉइंट हिंदू फैमिली बिजनेस. वो बेटे जॉइंट हिंदू फैमिली बिजनेस होता है बिकॉज दे पीपल आर रनिंग इट विद द फैमिली, दे पीपल आर रनिंग इट विद द जॉइंट फैमिली, सो दैट इज अ जॉइंट हिंदू फैमिली बिजनेस. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. वी विल बी स्टडिंग दिस इन टू डिटेल. नाउ द थर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ बिजनेस अवेलेबल विच यू कैन डू इज partnership. Partnership we all are already aware of, because somewhere we are doing partnership in some of the business activity, in some of the economic or even non-economic activity also. So partnership would be just considered as where more than one person is there to work. Those who are engaged themselves into doing some job, more than one person is engaged in there. That is known as partnership. As you can see on your screen, two people at least are required to form a partnership. Can you tell me that only if only one person can make the partnership? Is it possible that only one person or the single owner can make the partnership? Of course, no. Because one person is ultimately the sole proprietor. He cannot be into the partnership. So for making the partnership business, how many people are required? At least two persons are required. At least two people. So in the partnership business, we require at least two people to start the partnership business. Do they have the common goal in partnership? Or they will be working as per their own needs? Please tell me, do they have the common goal into the partnership, or they will be just working as per their need? Jaise unko kaam karna hai. Of course, they have the common goal. They have the common goal only. Why? Because they are in the partnership business. Suppose me and Mridul both have committed hands. Joined hands to make a partnership business where we both have a common goal of making, suppose, a bridge, constructing a bridge, or any of the common goal. So both of us will be doing towards that goal only. We'll be going towards that goal because that is our common objective. So every time, please keep this in your mind, that partnership people, the people who are entering into partnership, they have a common goal, they have a common objective, and every one of them is working for that objective only. if any one of them would not be going for that objective, they would not be able to achieve their target. They would not be able to achieve their goal. So definitely, every one of them is having a common objective. A common objective in the sense where we simply say that every one of them is ultimately working for the same goal. Every one of them is working for the same goal. All right. Now, after the three forms of business organizations, we have the fourth form of business organization, cooperative societies. Have you people ever heard about the word cooperative societies? Ever heard of the cooperative societies? Cooperative means milker. Cooperative way, in a cooperative way, where people are coming together. Sir, if this is also cooperative, people are coming together, people are joining together, sir, then what is the difference between partnership and cooperative society? But a cooperative society is formed to help its own members. Cooperative society is made to help its own members. Right? For example, Farmers Cooperative Society. Farmers Cooperative Society. Farmers Cooperative Society means where all the farmers are coming together, joining together to form a society. They all are joining together to form a society. For example, where all the farmers are pulling up their money, are pulling up their resources to form a common society so that they are going to help each one of them when needed. So this is that form of business which is being raised by the members, by the people to form it as a cooperative society so that each one of them is going to help them, help themselves in fact. For example, if in a cooperative society, in a group, Mr. A requires help, so all the members of that cooperative society are definitely going to help Mr. A. That form of business is cooperative societies. Then we have fifth and last form of business, that is joint stock company. This is very common form of business. And of course, now, if we talk about these days, this form of business is on rise. Joint stock companies, where people are forming a bigger companies. They are forming joint stock companies where everybody is just putting up some shares, some investment, and on the combined of framing a company, and that company works for various objectives. All these malls, shopping malls, which you people see, even big business houses like Hindustan Unilever Limited, Reliance, Tata, all these are companies. They have formed as a joint stock company where all members have invested some share, some investment. The company is made as per the law, as per the Companies Act 2013, and it is working as per that. You know, earlier companies were formed with the previous law, Purane Kanun ke tahat, which was Companies Act 1956. But now that law has revised and that law has changed into Companies Act 2013. And now the company is working as per that. So joint stock company is the fifth form of business which you can open. Prakshal Jain, I will cut your marks because you are not in school uniform. So these are the five different forms of business organizations that you can open. First, I told you sole proprietorship. where the one is the single owner, the person is the sole owner, and he is only the one who is running the whole business. No one else is there. Second, joint Hindu family business. This is that form of business where people are doing the business in a joint family, where there is one head of the family. Tell me what name I had already given to the head of the family. I just told you in the beginning. Who is called as head of the family in the joint Hindu family business? Very good, everyone. Karta. Karta is called as the head of the family. You know, almost three generations can work together in the joint Hindu family business. Aapke dadaji, aapke pitaji, aur aap. Three generations together work in the joint Hindu family business. So it's a joint family business, right? Then third, we did partnership, where I told you that partnership refers to that form of business organization. Partnership refers to that form of business organization where more than two people are there who are joining their hands, to ultimately form a business, and they will be doing it for the common goals. They would be doing it for the common objective. Because if two people are there in the business and one is doing some other activity, the other one is doing some other activity, of course, they would not be able to target, ultimately to achieve the target which they have set. So in the partnership business, remember always that they have always a common goal. And of course, law is there according to which they people have to work, or according to which they people have to join their hands. Next, we did, after partnership, cooperative society, where I told you already that cooperative society refers to that society, or cooperative society refers to that business activity where people have joined their hands as a member, they have pooled up their resources, and they are there for the achievement of the common goal, but helping their own member. All right? Like, we have many cooperative societies. One of the example I give you, housing cooperative society, where people make buildings all together, pulling up their resources, they make building all together. And ultimately, out of that building, they distribute the land, or they distribute the flats made out of that with each member of them. Then fifth form of business is joint stock company. Joint stock company means when we simply say that joint stock company is that company where people are investing their money. And as per the law, they are going to work. That is joint stock company. I hope this is clear to everyone till now. So let us study the first, that is sole proprietorship, in detail. So now we are going to start the sole proprietorship in detail. So please make first heading in your notebook, that is sole proprietorship. So after different forms of business organizations introduction that you studied, we are going to now start with the first form of business organization in detail, and its name is sole proprietorship. You can write the meaning of sole proprietorship first. Arnav, please switch off your camera and switch it on once again because it is coming black only. So, sole proprietorship. What will be the meaning of sole proprietorship first? So definitely we are going to write its meaning in two words only, as the business is of only two words. Sole, that is single. Sole means single. And proprietorship means ownership. Proprietorship means ownership, which means we can say that sole proprietorship is single ownership. Sole proprietorship is single ownership. All right. That means sole proprietorship is basically that form of business which is owned. Owned matlab jiska malik, which is managed. Managed matlab jisko sare decisions lene hai, एंड विच इज कंट्रोल्ड. कंट्रोल्ड मतलब जिसको एक बंदा ही कंट्रोल करेगा, बाय एन इंडिविजुअल. दैट मीन्स वी कैन सिंपली से दैट सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप इज दैट फॉर्म ऑफ बिजनेस जिसको एक बंदा ओन करता है, विच इज जस्ट ओन्ड बाय ओनली वन पर्सन, विच इज मैनेज्ड बाय ओनली वन पर्सन, एंड ऑफ कोर्स विच इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय ओनली वन पर्सन. सो दिस देयर इज ओनली वन पर्सन हु इज अल्टीमेटली गोइंग टू हैव अ कंप्लीट कंट्रोल ओवर दैट बिजनेस. नो वन एल्स विल बी देयर. टेल मी हु विल टेक ऑल द डिसीजंस देन. Who will take all the decisions then? Obviously, all the decisions will be taken by the sole owner only, the sole proprietor, right? The sole proprietor or the sole owner, he is going to take up the all decisions. All the decisions he will be taking. Can you tell me what can be the benefit of the sole proprietor if he is going to take sole decisions? What can be the benefit? You know, there will be the quick decision making. He don't have to wait for the others, right? He have to take the quick decisions. Kartik, obviously there would be some staff which he will be hiring, and that staff will be its employees. But who is the owner? Owner is only one person. Who is the sole proprietor, right? Staff of course can be there, but he will be the sole owner. And being a sole owner, definitely there would not be any conflicts in the organization, in its business. Why? Because if they would have some partnership, then definitely there are chances of conflicts. Ladai jhagde ke chances jyada hain. Because you never know that what decision I am going to take, my partner is not liking that decision. Kai baar hota hai, hum do log milke kya karte hain? We purchase a land and building. Suppose we have purchased a flat of rupees 60 lakhs. Me and my friend in partnership purchased one flat for rupees 50 lakhs. After keeping that flat for 1 year, because of lack of money that I am having, lack of money, so I just want to sell my flat so that I can have at least 25 to 30 lakhs in my hands. Whereas my partner, my friend, doesn't want to sell that flat at that time because he's saying that selling the flat at that time would not be giving you more profit. He wants to wait for more 1 year. Ho gaya conflict? The conflict is arisen. Why? Because you both of your mindset is different. You want to sell it at this point of time, whereas your friend doesn't want to sell it at that point of time. So conflict arises in the form of partnership. But what if it is a sole ownership? Will that conflict arise in the sole ownership? Not at all. You? Because I am the only owner. I have purchased that flat with my name. I am free to sell it at any time. No conflict will arise in that time. Is it clear? Okay. Tell me who will be the sole profit recipient in sole proprietorship. Obviously the sole owner, because he is the one working. When he is the one working, he'll be getting the complete profit. When he is the sole owner working, he will be getting the complete profit. So he is responsible for all his profits. And who will bear the risk? If you are going to earn the profit, then who will bear the risk also? Obviously, the sole owner only is going to bear the risk. Owner will bear the risk. You? Because when you are getting the profit, then why your friend will bear the risk? It's your business. You are the owner. You will be bearing the whole risk as well. So sole proprietorship refers to that form of business which is owned, managed and controlled by single individual. He is the recipient of all profits, and also he is the bearer of the complete risk, or he is the bearer of all risks also. Can I say sole proprietor to be one man army? He is the one man army because he is the one who is taking care of the complete business. So he would be known as one man army. So if any question, if it comes that one man army is always good, explain. So definitely you have to explain the sole proprietorship with its merits, advantages of the business. I hope this is clear till now. Meaning of sole proprietorship is clear. That what is sole proprietorship? Now moving on. Now what are the features of sole proprietorship? See, features means what? Characteristics this business possesses. The first is very easy point, that is easy formation and closure. you know, is it? It is very easy to form the sole proprietorship business, and also it is very easy to close the sole proprietorship business. You can form the sole proprietorship business very easily, as well as you can close this business very easily. There is no hard and fast rule which is to be applied on this business. And also there is no legal constraint. There is no legal restriction which have been imposed before starting the sole proprietorship business. You are free to start the sole proprietorship business anytime. So it is very easy to form and easy to close the business. All right. Then we have the second one. The second is one man ownership and control. One man ownership and control. Obviously, the characteristic, this is only one man army. I told you it's one man ownership and control. That only one man is there who is actually having the complete ownership over the business. And also he is only having the control, full control. Control here means whatever decisions will be taken into the business, all the decisions will be taken up by the sole owner only. All the decisions will be taken up by the sole proprietor only. So it is a one man ownership and a one man control in this business. Then sole risk bearer and recipient of profit. You know, sole proprietorship, it is a sole risk bearer, which means he is the single one who is going to bear the complete risk. He is the single one who is going to bear the risk completely. No one else would bear the liability. No one else would bear the risk. He will be solely bearing the complete risk. And of course, he is the recipient of profit also, because he is the sole person who is managing the business, who is owning the business, who is controlling the business. So definitely he is the one who is actually having the full recipient of profit. He is the one who is generating the complete profit also, right? Then unlimited liability. Unlimited liability means, suppose in any case, he fails to pay his debts. Suppose the sole owner has taken the loan. Please listen to this point very carefully, because this is very, 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 very important point. Suppose sole proprietor has taken loan from a bank. He has taken the loan of rupees 1 lakh, right? Now his business is getting into losses and he is unable to pay the loan. Can sole proprietor say that me and my business are different? Can he say that? Me and my business are different. He cannot say that. He cannot say that, which means he is having the unlimited liability. Unlimited liability means his personal property, his personal assets can be fetched to pay out the debts of the business. Uske business ke debts ko, uske business ki liability ko, uske business ke creditors ko pay karne ke liye, uski jo personal assets hain, unko bhi fetch kiya ja sakta hai by the bank. And he has to definitely take care of it. So there is unlimited liability in the sole proprietorship business, because he's the single owner, he's taking all the decisions. Then no separate entity. No separate entity means in the sole proprietorship, there is no separate legal entity. It is completely his business. There is no separate law under which that business is formed. So we will simply say that no separate legal entity is there. He and his business are same. Please write down this. No separate entity means he and his business are same. I got a question from Tanishq. Sir, if the sole proprietor dies, then what happens to business? Obviously, who will run the business if sole proprietor dies? The business would be closed. The business would get shut down, because no other owner is there. In spite of if any member of the family is there who take over it again, that is a different concept. Otherwise, if no one is there and the sole proprietor dies, his business would be just turned off, shut down, right? So no separate entity is there. That means no legal entity is there. He is the only person and no separate entity is getting. He and his business are same. And last point, last feature, lack of continuity of business. Tanishq, your answer. Lack of continuity of business. If a person dies, if a sole proprietor dies, there is a high chance that the continuity of business is hindered. There is a high chance that the continuity of business is suffering. So there is lack of continuity of the business. I hope all the features of sole proprietorship are clear. We have today, I've introduced you about the different forms of business organizations that a person can start. And secondly, I told you about the second concept, the first major concept of the form of business organization, that is sole proprietorship, that how business is formed as a sole proprietorship, how it is run as a sole proprietorship. And we have done its meaning and features. Tomorrow we will study its advantages and disadvantages. All right, is it clear to everyone? Any doubt in the sole proprietorship? Sitakshi has a doubt. Sir, who will pay the debt that he has taken after he dies? His personal assets will be fetched. If his personal assets are there, those personal assets would be fetched, and accordingly the debts will be paid.